Hey there, and welcome to another Devlog. So yeah, what has happened in the last month or so? Well, first off, I began streaming over on Twitch. I tried to stream 3 times a week, yes. And yeah, the streams are mostly about level design, 3D modeling, and stuff like that. So yeah, but that's not why you're here. So let's now talk about what is new in Calamity. So what's new? I added a fog shader. The shader kind of consists of 3 different parts. A post-process volume, which uses a material that just blends in a color with opacity to simulate fog. I'll link a good tutorial from PrismaticaDev for doing that in the description. The other part is a spline blueprint that uses a simple plane mesh with a fog material I made. And the last part is a NIAGARA particle system, which is also using the mesh and fog material. The end result of that is a shader that looks like this. The post-process shader uses the blend radius to blend in the fog. If you have the bug that this does not work, there's a link on how to fix that in the description. It took me ages to find out how to fix that, and the solution is a bit weird. Next up, I also made the cages that hang from poles have physics, so you can bump into them and make them swing. Quite honestly, I'm proud of how that turned out, because that took longer than I want to admit. The problem was not to make it work, the time-consuming part was to find the right constraints for the cages, so that they won't spaz out and go all over the place. So let's now talk about the new enemies. I made a new type of enemy, they are called the Despaired. They are kind of like the Hollows from Dark Souls. They can have different equipment like two-handed swords, maces and so on. This will affect their attack patterns and the damage they deal. Some of them will also wear armor later on. They will have a chance to drop the equipment that they are wearing. This is kind of what I'm going for with the loot system, so you can potentially see what you will get from an enemy, but more on the loot system in another devlog. There are also different versions of the Despaired, like the crawler and the one with one leg. These will have different movement speeds and are most of the time not that dangerous, but can get pretty nasty if they swarm you. I also added one of them as an archer. At the moment he's using a placeholder bow and arrows. I haven't found the time to model a new one, but he's working and it spices up the combat a bit. Finally, the player now can also lose all of his gear upon death. Here a shout out to Kaidom, who's the creator of the action RPG multiplayer starter template which I'm using, link in the description. He showed me how to implement that. So, but now let's talk about the sweet stuff, more level design. I did quite a lot of level design on the Twitch streams, so let me show you the results of that. I built a foggy forest area which turned out pretty beautiful to be honest. Here is where all the fog shaders are coming into play and really give this area its charm and its looks. There is a little hidden cabin in the forest, which at the moment is empty but will end up having some loot and maybe the chance to spawn an NPC. After that I built the end of the other forest area and mainly reworked the camp located there and also adjusted the landscape to feel more natural. One of the main things I did to the whole area and the whole map is to give the landscape a more natural look. I also added way more slopes to the terrain and gave the pathways more detail so that they look a bit more used or walked. Next up was editing a bit of the area underneath the foggy forest and the first big camp. I added a little hill area underneath the forest where the players can go to find a hidden lake and also another little ruin. This ruin will have the chance to spawn some loot. The area underneath the big camp should look like it was cut down by the people who made the camp and they used the trees to build the fortifications of the camp. I also want to add some training dummies where the white blocks are at the moment, but I need to make some more assets for that. After all of this, the next step was to begin plotting out a new area which will end up being a ruined town. To explain how I tackled the level design of these smaller areas for Calamity, let us again take a look at Elden Ring. In the last devlog I made about level design, we covered how Elden Ring slices its open world into different continents or map parts. Caution, Elden Ring spoilers ahead. Let's now take a closer look at some of the areas in these map parts. Elden Ring separates some sections of its open world into little pieces and dungeon-like areas. It makes a perfect job at combining real big open world areas with constraints for where the players can go, effectively morphing some open areas in a kind of dungeon-like design. A good example for this is the Dominula Windmill Village in Elden Ring. If we draw in the cliffs and then take a look at where the players can go and can't go, the player will come from down here. He can not jump over these ledges, but he can jump back down these ledges. If we keep this in mind, we can cut the Windmill Village down to different little areas the players have to traverse. At the top of the village we can find a boss, just like we would in a dungeon. Elden Ring is using this level design technique very often, and it's rather rare to see a completely wide open area. The advantage of designing different areas like this, especially in a game like Elden Ring, is that you can better design the encounters that you want the players to have at a specific point. In the example of the Windmill Village, not every enemy will attack you straight away. You will only get attacked at a certain point in the village. This is clearly by design, and it evokes a specific atmosphere for the players. And there's also a lore rabbit hole in why that may be the way it is. I just realized while writing this script that this is the exact opposite of level design from Zelda Breath of the Wild, where the whole world basically can be traversed from any angle. But now let's come back to Calamity. In Calamity I want to take a similar approach like the one in Elden Ring, which can best be seen here on the example of this ruined town. We will have many entry points to this town, but only two exit points. This is one draft of how this area could be in terms of level design. We are also tiling this area in different parts, just like in the example of Elden Ring. If the players are traversing the area, they will encounter enemies at some specific points, but enemies will also roam this area. The enemies are also kind of guarding some of the loot. Of course, the enemies will drop loot, so areas with a high density of enemies are always good to go to. Later I also would love to have a higher tier enemy roaming around in the area, kind of like an area boss. I also have something planned for the area down here, but I don't want to spoil that yet. Lastly, I began updating the Action RPG template. The update fixes some stuff and also gives me more options on designing the game. I especially needed the modular armor pieces that were implemented, so I can hide the underlying layer of the character if the players equip new armor pieces, so we don't have clipping. And this was included in the new update. The bad news are that I have to create a new project to update the plugin, and I need to redo some of the things I have already implemented, like the custom character blueprint and all of the movement of the character, the weapons need to be re-implemented, and also all the enemies and some other stuff. But I'm making good progress on that, and I have a good amount of stuff in there already, so I hope to have everything ported at the end of the month. But today I encountered this. Turns out, Unreal does not like to migrate foliage from one project to another. This basically means I will have to redo all the foliage of the map, which sucks, but it's fine. I think this will take 1 or 2 days extra, but yeah, shit happens. My major goal for the end of the year is to finally have something playable ready, like a technical demo. And yeah, I don't know if I will put the technical demo online, but what I want to do is to have some people over, drink a beer or something, and let them try out the demo so that I can get a bit of feedback and stuff like that. So yeah, I really hope that I will be able to achieve that. by the end of the year, but yeah. So stay tuned for the next devlog, and once again, thank you all so much for watching the videos, watching the streams. You guys are totally awesome, and yeah, we will see us in the next devlog.
Yeah, that's true. Shit needs to sack hard.